Secure in peace, mindful of peril, preparedness ensures safety. Good morning, today is Monday, March 25, 2024. Today in history, 106 years ago today, French composer Claude Debussy passed away. Renowned for compositions such as Afternoon of the Faun and Nocturne, his music exudes a unique blend of strange fantasy and hazy, sensual colors. Debussy's innovative approach and incorporation of Impressionist elements had a profound impact on the European music scene at the turn of the 20th century, solidifying his legacy as a pioneer of modern Impressionism in music. Qingqiao, bridging the business world and delivering information to you. Welcome to today's Qingqiao Morning News. Let's start with political updates. Vo Tian Xien appointed acting chairman in Vietnam. According to the Vietnam News Agency, the Standing Committee of the National Assembly of Vietnam has recently announced that Vice President Vo Tian Xien will assume the role of acting president of the country. Vo Tian Xien, born in January 1970 in An Giang Province, southern Vietnam, has a long-standing career in her hometown and has served as secretary of the An Giang Provincial Committee of the Communist Party of Vietnam. She was elected as an alternate member of the 11th Central Committee of the Communist Party of Vietnam in 2011 and later became a member of the 12th and 13th Central Committee. In 2021, she was elected as the Vice President of Vietnam. Before this announcement, reports submitted by the Central Inspection Committee of the Communist Party of Vietnam and other relevant departments highlighted that former Vietnamese President Vo Van Thuong had violated the regulations governing the behavior of Communist Party members. As a member of the Central Committee of the Communist Party of Vietnam, a member of the Political Bureau of the Central Committee, and a member of the Secretariat of the Central Committee, Vo Van Thuong failed to fulfill his duties as a role model. His shortcomings and mistakes have had a negative impact on public opinion and have tarnished the prestige of the party, the country, and himself. Vo Van Thuong acknowledged his shortcomings and submitted his resignation from various positions to the Central Committee of the Communist Party of Vietnam, expressing his desire to retire. South Korea revokes licenses of striking doctors. According to Yonhap News Agency, Park Min-soo, the second director of the Ministry of Public Health and Welfare of South Korea, recently announced that, starting from March 25, the government will generally revoke the medical licenses of doctors who violate the order to return to work. Park Min-soo reiterated his appeal to resident interns who are not on duty, urging them to immediately return to the intern hospital for the sake of their patients, their colleagues who remain at their posts, and their original intention of choosing a career as a doctor. The South Korean government's decision to recruit an additional 2,000 medical school freshmen annually from 2025, announced in early February, sparked strong opposition from practicing doctors. In late February, more than 9,000 intern residents went on strike. Since March 5, the government has issued advance notices of administrative sanctions, such as license revocation, to approximately 9,000 professional intern doctors who have not resumed work. As per South Korea's Ministry of Public Health and Welfare, all internship hospitals must update the appointment status of intern residents in the internship management system by the end of March. Failure to do so will prevent those intending to start internships this year from doing so, and they will not be eligible to become resident physicians next year. According to South Korea's Specialist Physician Internship and Qualification Regulations, intern residents must undergo additional internships if absent from internships for more than 1 month. Extended internship beyond 3 months may result in a delay of 1 year in obtaining specialist qualifications. Secondly, we'll bring you updates on military-related news. Russian missile attack on Kyiv injures 17 people. According to comprehensive news from Moscow, on March 21, Russia launched 31 missiles towards Kyiv, the capital of Ukraine, injuring 17 people. This marks the largest airstrike Kyiv has suffered in recent times following Russian President Vladimir Putin's pledge to retaliate against Ukraine for increased attacks on the Russian border. Local officials in Kyiv reported that around 3 a.m. on that day, the city sounded an air defense siren. Falling missile fragments injured 13 people in Kyiv and 4 people in surrounding areas. Missile fragments caused fires on the roofs of an electrical substation, multiple residential buildings, and several vehicles. Following the incident, Ukrainian President Zelensky took to social media, urging Western countries to provide Ukraine with more air defense systems. He emphasized that such terrorist acts occur nearly every day, underscoring Ukraine's urgent need for advanced missile systems for defense. Now, let's turn our attention to the latest economic news. EU imposes new restrictions on Ukrainian grain exports. According to Reuters, on March 20, the European Union reached a temporary agreement allowing Ukrainian food producers to access its market duty-free until June 2025. However, the agreement also imposes new restrictions on grain imports. In January of this year, the European Commission proposed the suspension of tariffs and quota restrictions on Ukrainian agricultural products for another year. However, certain restrictions were suggested for agricultural items like poultry, eggs, and sugar. Should the EU imports of these products from Ukraine surpass certain levels, tariffs equivalent to the average levels in 2021, 2022, and 2023 would be imposed. Ukrainian farmers strongly objected to this proposal. After 2 months of negotiations, the European Commission agreed to include oats, corn, hulled oats, and honey in the list, though the import limit reference would be based on the average levels of 2022 and 2023. The interim agreement still requires approval from the European Parliament and EU governments, and is expected to be implemented in April of this year. Malaysia Airlines reports first profit in full year, RM 760 million. Recently, Malaysia Airlines Group held a performance conference, as reported by Malaysian Sinchu News. The data presented indicated that by December 31, 2023, the Malaysia Airlines Group's annual turnover surged to 13.85 billion ringgit, marking a remarkable 31% year-on-year increase. In terms of operating profit, the group achieved RM 889 million in revenue, reflecting a significant 64% year-on-year growth. Executive Director of Malaysia Airlines Berhad, Data Captain Ism bin Ismail, expressed that this marks the first time in the group's history to record a net profit, underscoring its robust performance. Malaysia Airlines has faced consecutive losses since its listing in 1994. Following the Asian financial crisis in 1997, the Malaysian government acquired Malaysia Airlines shares and converted it into a state-owned enterprise. In 2014, the airline faced further challenges with the disappearance of flight MH370 and the downing of flight MH17 over Ukraine. These incidents exacerbated its financial struggles. Consequently, Malaysia Airlines was delisted, and a restructuring plan involving an RM 6 billion investment was initiated. In 2020, an additional RM 5 billion was injected into Malaysia Airlines by the Malaysian authorities through Khazanah Nasional. Now, here is some important safety information. South Korean oil tanker capsizes off Japanese coast, 8 dead. According to reports from agents France Presse and Kyoto News on March 20, a South Korean oil tanker capsized off the coast of Japan with 11 people on board. NHK reported that the tanker broke down due to adverse weather conditions. Subsequently, the crew contacted the Japan Coast Guard, informing them that the ship was listing and requesting assistance near the Rokurian Islands off Japan's southwest coast. NHK provided video footage showing a lifeboat near the overturned oil tanker, with the Coast Guard vessel navigating through massive waves to conduct the rescue operation, while a helicopter flew overhead. A spokesperson for the Japan Coast Guard stated that the tanker was constructed in 1996 and served as a chemical and petroleum product tanker, measuring 69 meters in length. At the time of the incident, there were 11 crew members on board. Regrettably, 8 of them succumbed to injuries in the hospital, 1 sustained non-life-threatening injuries, and the whereabouts of the remaining 2 were unknown. Additionally, the tanker was carrying 980 tons of acrylic acid, raising concerns about potential chemical leakage into the ocean, though this remains uncertain. Finally, here's some intriguing cultural news. Thailand seeks World Intangible Cultural Heritage Status for Wai Kru. According to news from Bangkok, Thailand's Minister of Education Prumpun Chitchob recently chaired the 11th Ministry of Education Task Coordination meeting in 2024. One of the topics discussed at this meeting was the application of Thailand's Wycur ceremony as a World Heritage Site. Minister Prumpun mentioned that applying to UNESCO to list the Wycur ceremony as a World Intangible Cultural Heritage involves numerous details and is expected to take about 6 months. Over the next 6 months, Thailand will diligently prepare to apply for the Wycur ceremony to be recognized as part of the world's intangible cultural heritage. The Wycur ceremony holds significant cultural importance in Thailand, symbolizing the tradition of honoring teachers. By seeking World Heritage status for this ceremony, Thailand aims to promote a deeper understanding of its culture of teacher reverence. This recognition will encourage students to respect and appreciate their teachers, uphold the teacher-student relationship, and foster a positive educational environment. Financial newsletter. The Container Shipping Index, European Line, futures have surged recently, with the main contract EC2404 closing up 9.88% to 2096.8 points, and the submain contract EC2406 closing at the limit of 1827.4 points. That's all for today's Qingqiao Morning News. Thank you for listening.